Hey friends, hey family, como estas? Bienvenidos. If you want to see all of the goods, face full of reviews, and a face full of hair products in review, then keep watching. It's the Haul Report. Hey friends, hey family, como estas? Bienvenidos. It's your girl Melissa Q back for another video. And in today's video, I am going to do a face full of favorites, or a face full of products that I've tried and I love, and I just did a full face of it, and I'm going to show you what I used in my hair. I love it. It's giving me volume. It's giving me life. Yes, and I just want to share with you guys the products and do some mini reviews. So let's jump into the video. Let's start off with this product. I use the Rice Daily Brightening Cleansing Tissues. These I like a lot. This was a recommendation by Young, Wild, and Polished here on YouTube. I love these so much. I use these in the morning to just refresh and get any dirt or anything. It doesn't contain alcohol. It's from this brand called Skin Food. I am trying a primer and a toner from them currently, but I have broken into this. It has a good amount too. I feel like that these are good and juicy, and this does not expire until 2021. But let me tell you, if you want your product to last, try to keep this right here on it, the sticker, and you can actually store it upside down. That way all the juices get to the top. So good. But anyway, really like this. I would repurchase these, and they smell so good. I actually picked up both of these from the Sephora VIB sale, and this is the Ole Henriksen Sea Rush Brightening Gel Cream and also the Banana Bright Eye Cream. Now, I really like this. This is the thing with me and eye creams. I can't give you a definitive answer on this yet. It does brighten up the under eye, having some slight like illumination, kind of like my ginseng eye cream from Origins. Although that one really deep puffs, so that one still trumps this one. I really do like this product a lot, and I definitely see the hydration there, and I definitely see it like brightening up a little bit. But in terms of deep puffing, I'm sure it will improve the dark circles. That's what the purpose, that's what the claims are, but we'll see about that one. I can't give you a definitive answer, but I can tell you that currently it is hydrating and brightening the under eye a little bit. Now, let's get to the Sea Rush Brightening Gel Cream. I actually was hoping to like the eye cream more so than the Gel Rush. I actually got the set because of this, but I actually like the gel cream better than the under eye cream. Just because I have this, this is a texture that I'm not used to, and it smells so good. A little bit goes a long way, and your face feels refreshed. I feel like if you have oily skin, but your skin is like dry and may have dry patches or anything, this one is good because it's a gel cream. So it's a mix between a gel and a creamy moisturizer. It has the vitamin C. It wakes up the skin. It kind of does the same thing as the Origins, the ginseng, from the ginseng line. I feel like it wakes up the skin. I really do enjoy this gel cream, and just from this travel size, which I got these because I'm going to be traveling this summer, and so I'm definitely going to be using these, but that's definitely a moisturizer I could see myself repurchasing for sure. Let's move on to the Milk Hydro Grip Primer. Love it, love it, love it, love it. Okay, it's tacky. It still gives me kind of like a glow. I would say as of right now, this is in my top three of primers. I like those glowy primers, but this one actually, I feel like it smooths out my skin. Now, I know that this one is really good at hydrating, and so this one, the reason why I like this one is because I feel like it could be a year-round type of it's gonna like make anything, first of all, stick to it. It's going to allow the foundation to glide over it. Not to say that this is a smoothing type of primer, but I feel like it just allows everything to glide, and although it sticks, it just evenly distributes the foundation on top of it. Back the Giorgio Armani Fluid Sheer. I like this. This is like a peachy, it's like a peachy gold. Let me swatch it just a little bit. This is so good to give you that nice, it's tinted, it's slightly tinted, so doesn't matter to me what skin tone you are, but it gives that nice glow. And although it has like glow, like gold flecks, although it has those gold flecks, it's not chunky on the skin. It gives a nice glow. And I like it so much. It just lays down so pretty. And as you can tell, it does have a slight glow to it. But you can mix it to your moisturizer. It's not going to disturb the foundation. It's just a nice liquidy. You could actually wear it by yourself. If I was, I still, because I have dry skin, normal to dry skin, I still mix this in with a moisturizer, but I could do this, a moisturizer, and go. This, to me, is more of a glow product, and it's going to give you that bronze glow, so it's perfect for summer. Before talking about foundations, let's go to my concealer combos. Okay, the Prep and Prime, this is the highlighter, Prep and Prime highlighter in Peach Luster. As you can tell, I really like this. I love the fact that you can paint it on. It's really easy to apply. I just really like this. It's not brightening like my Naked Skin one, but I really like it. If you have deep dark circles, that peach, it's a deep peach. That one is the one to get. I really like it, and I feel like it takes the grayness from under eyes. So if you have some grayness that's still seeping through, then you need to get a deeper peachy undertone to counteract that, and that one does really, really well. Let's talk about the Estee Lauder Double Wear and the Bare Skin. This one is closer to my skin tone, but it's one shade lighter. This one is in 3W medium warm. I love this concealer. Now, I did set it with a powder just because if I want my foundation to stay all day, I did take the primer, the Hydro Grip, and go under the eye too, which is one of the reasons why I really like this primer. But this Double Wear, I really like this. Now, Tati talked about liking this concealer so much, and this Double Wear, I feel like that they have good shades, and it's, if you like the Estee Lauder Double Wear foundation, you will like the concealer, I feel like. Now, the Bare Skin, this is really good for brightening. Now, it's very serum-y, so if you have a drier concealer like the NARS, what's that, the one that's in the pot, I want to say that's like a matte, putting something like this over and blending it out would be perfect, because anything that's going to dry out the under eye, but you really like the formula, Bare Skin is something that you probably want to put under it. I would have to get this in my regular skin tone. This is in medium, but I feel like it's still way brighter. These both are in medium. This one has a yellower undertone. This one really brightens, so I try to keep it in the same area. But it's beautiful in terms of brightening the under eye. It is thin. I wouldn't say that this is a full coverage. This one is a full coverage concealer. So I really do like this, but for different purposes. This one for brightening. This one for keeping it in place. It ain't going nowhere. Moving on to foundation, let's talk about it. Minted Skin foundation sticks. These are so good. This is the closest shade to my skin tone that I have ever seen in a foundation stick. I am currently wearing L20. I do have L40, but I feel like that this is going to be closer to my skin tone in the summertime. Okay, but this one is the one that's currently, this formula is so hydrating. Minted, you did that with the foundation sticks. I love it so much. If you have normal to dry skin to combo skin, you will really like these. If you want to use something natural and fresh during the summer months and you're oily, you're going to have to use a powder with these. But I really do enjoy it. I did sculpt my cheekbones with, or I used it as a liquid, not a cream bronzer. I did use this as a cream bronzer. This is T40. I love the shade so much. I could even go maybe a shade deeper than this, but I love it. It just gives the perfect like sculpt, and it's natural. I love it so much, and it does give a nice like fresh glow to the skin. I feel like that you could build this up to mediums, like sheer to medium with this. I prefer a brush. It did come in the PR package with a brush. You don't have to get this brush, but this brush is a good brush. If you're getting these, highly recommend, if you don't have a brush like this, then getting something like this brush. I know e.l.f. has a brush like this, but I'm going to tell you, I can tell in the quality of this, it does not shed as much as my e.l.f. brush. And the ferrule, a lot of times the ferrule of my e.l.f. brushes sometimes will loosen up, and I love that this one is further down. So I love that you can sculpt it. You can use this as your foundation. I just highly recommend using a brush rather than a sponge with this. And speaking of a sponge, because I did blend out my concealer with this, this is the Sonia Kashuk blender. It did come 2 in a pack. It's the better deal getting 2 in a pack. This is such a good sponge. Say what, Beauty Blender? What? Who is that? Let's move on to powder. This is the Graftopian Professional Makeup. Y'all saw me set this under eye. This is in the shade Banana Cream Pie. I haven't talked about this, but this is such a good powder. This is probably the best brightening under eye for my skin tone. I feel like if you are my skin tone or a tad bit deeper, you're going to love this even if you have deep. This beats. It's more finely milled than Banana Nye. I like it better than the Beauty Bakery, just because Beauty Bakery sometimes can dry me out a little bit. But this one is more brightening. You can tell it's a more like high color of yellow. So I really do like that. And you saw me go in with my Fenty bronzer. I like this a lot. This is in Caramel Cutie. I did get the small one, and I got the matchstick. This came in a set from my Sephora VIP sale. I love these so much. Now, this, if you could tell, I set my bronzer from the Minted with this. I feel like because the cheek area is usually the first place to fade and break up right in here, I wanted to set that. And I still got glow. And this is the thing I love about the matchsticks and about the Benefit What's Up. These do not disturb. Oh, and also the Milk makeup. Okay, these do not disturb my foundation. I use it on my hands to warm it up a little bit, and I pat it. But this is the matchstick in Cinnamon, and I really, really like this shade. If you are a deeper skin tone, you can definitely use this as actually a blush topper or even to top the bronze. I really wouldn't use this because it's matte. I would use this as a highlighter though. If I wanted more of a bronzy highlighter rather than a gold, that one's really pretty. But the Benefit What's Up is so beautiful, and it has where you can kind of dab it. I feel like it would pick up the product, so you could just use your fingers. And this is such a beautiful, it's very balmy, very glass like and that's where you see that glow, like right around the orbital bone right here. So that is so pretty. You can even mix them, but that's such a beautiful cream. Both of those I love. All of these products I love. Okay, why am I talking about this? Because I've already reviewed them. But anyway, that's that glow that you're seeing right there. And then the Milk makeup. This is their Lip and Cheek. This is in Work. I should have used some around my lip. Hold on. You can just take it and work it on the lips. These type of balmy ones, to me, I don't have a problem with it disturbing my foundation. Now, I definitely would not do a rubbing motion. You definitely want to take it and you want to pat. Patting it is going to allow you to press the product into the skin while blending. So, really enjoy this product. Let's move on to eyes. This is the Colored Rain Queen of Hearts. A lot of people have been talking about this. I never came with a review. It looks like I have barely used this, but I love this so much. I've used a lot of these colors, but there are, let's see, pretty much all of them I have used, except I think Dethrone and Queen Mother. But all the other ones, oh my goodness, this shade right here, Your Majesty, Balm, Royal Prerogative, Royal Highness, Air, Crown. These are beautiful. I feel like the only thing missing in this palette is a black, and I really like it. I love my eye makeup. And this look, I used Empress, which is this orange shade. I used Royal Prerogative. I used Your Majesty. I used Duchess. Okay, those colors. I used the Giorgio Armani. This is the waterproof silk, smooth silk eye pencil. Huh, I love an eye pencil that has a smudger on it. As you can tell, I smudged the lower lash line, and then I used Duchess, I believe. Yes, I used it to press it and for it to set. I love this look so much. I also used the Lorac Lash Pomade. Really like it for fattening up my lashes. This is a great mascara to lay down before you want to put on lashes. It's like one of those good ones that's like going to thicken the lash band, or your lower lash is going to give you some volume there. I would use one to lengthen. I feel like that this one is a good one for volume, but not necessarily for lengthening. But I really do still like I really like it for a pre-lash, a pre-faux lash. Today I wanted to keep it simple with my lips, so I went in with a lip pencil, and this one is from Minted. This is the Peach Lip Pencil. I love this so much. It's just enough, like, oh yes. And then also their lip gloss, this is Pink About Me. So I took peach and pink, and I like both of those, but it gave such a beautiful like finish. These are non-sticky. I have talked about these lip glosses before, but they never came with one that's a pinky nude. They have one called Mauve Over Me that I absolutely love, but if you can tell, it gives you a nice gloss, but it's like one of those like balmy glosses. I love this so much, and oh, so pretty. It's so pretty. Okay, let's talk about this Kérastase. This is the Intense. This is an Advanced Scalp and Hair Concentrate. It's like a hair booster. It reminds me of my Nioxin hair booster. This one is really good. It's supposed to like intensify hair growth, and I really do like this a lot. I like this. I really do. And I do feel like it's making a difference. It's a hair serum, and I really do feel like that my roots feel a lot softer. I don't know if it's meant to like do that, but it's like a milky texture. It smells so good, and I feel like that my roots are not as like hard and brassy, and I do feel like it contains like some oils and stuff, but I just massage it. I do feel like in terms of growing back your hair, using something like this is not the only be all end all of everything. You definitely have to take care of your ends. What's the use of taking care of your scalp? And you can actually rub this throughout your whole head too. So I really do enjoy that. I really like that product. It has become my favorite massage hair like ordeal, like spa. This is the Mielle Mint Almond Oil, and it is so good. It promotes healthy hair and scalp. So I really do like it. It's a thin consistency. It has peppermint in it. It has sweet almond oil. You can definitely make this yourself, but why? I only pay like $8 for this, but it's really, really good. And it gives like a really good shine to your hair. If you want shine, if you want a good scalp massager type of oil, this is something that you want to go to. I have not done a full review on it, but I can definitely do it for you guys. This is the Aloe Whipped Butter Gel by Camille Rose. This one is more volumizing than the Almond Joy Twist Butter. If you find that the Almond Joy Twist Butter is a little bit too heavy for you, then you want something like the Aloe Butter Whipped Gel. I feel like that it's like the best of both worlds, it being like a gel cream. Okay, this one is so creamy. I've used it nonstop just because it's in a project pan of mine, but I love it so much. The Almond Joy Twist Butter would not even move like it. This one is. This is like a gel cream. So if you want hold, but you want you want some moisturization, this is a great product to utilize. Those are all the products. Full face and hair of reviews. Thank you so much for coming on and letting me show you all the good stuff that I have been loving lately. And definitely put a product that you have been loving lately this spring and summer down in the comments. I would love to see it. Thanks so much for watching, guys. I'll see you soon.